The family members killed had dual citizenship and lived in Mexico as missionaries. The group was traveling between their family's ranch in Chihuahua for a wedding in Sonora. A total of three cars making the trip. All three ambushed by criminal groups who shot and burned at least one of the vehicles with the victims inside.
There's a war between two cartels in northern Mexico. One is from the state of Sonora, the other one is from the state of Chihuahua.
And Denise LeBaron-Ramos, a KCK immigration lawyer and first cousin to one of the women killed, says this is a long-standing war over territory that divides the two states.
It used to be beautiful down there. Beautiful. We could walk the streets until midnight perfectly fine. We can't do that anymore.
Where there used to be a handful of cartels, she believes there are now dozens. And the description for the latest massacre is being relayed by the oldest sibling, who was able to get himself and his family away from the cartel.
The 13-year-old boy was able to reach the community after being lost, is what everybody was saying, for several hours.
We're told he hid the other surviving children in the bushes and went for help.
The U.S. government aided in receiving the five wounded children on the other side of the border and transporting them to the hospital to receive necessary medical treatment. This transportation happened via helicopters.
But Mexican citizens, along with their families back here in the States, say they need their streets to be safer now more than ever.
There's got to be changes. There's got to be safety implemented. This doesn't only affect the Mexicans. It doesn't only affect the Mexican side. It affects a lot of people here too. And families, huge families that are being hurt because of it.
Now, the attack prompted President Trump to say this is time for Mexico, with the help of the United States, to wage war on the drug cartels. At 10, I'll have how family responds to his call of action. Ashanti Ford, Fox 4 News.